There was a court ruling earlier this week that could affect voter ID laws across the United States. A federal judge in Wichita ruled that both Kansas and Arizona can indeed ask for more proof of citizenship from voters. For more, we're joined now by Alan Gomez, who covers immigration for USA Today. So this is for state and for federal elections. What's this ruling mean?
What it means is if you register to vote in Kansas or Arizona, and you sign up with a federal registration form, that the feds now have to amend their form to require the additional proof of citizenship that those states require. So this has been a long battle that we've been having between states and federal governments. The states want to require more proof of citizenship. Bring your passport, bring your birth certificate, something like that. The federal government, all they require is that you sign and attest to the fact that you're a U.S. citizen. So that's the problem that we're having. So Arizona and Kansas are trying to get the federal government to change their voter registration forms to reflect those additional requirements that they have in those states.
And what about other states? Are they watching this?
Absolutely. There's two other states, Georgia and Alabama, have passed similar laws, so they may jump onto this very quickly. It's a little late in the legislative session for any other states to pass similar laws this year, but proponents of these kind of bills say that this ruling, if it stands, will open the door for more states to require more proof of citizenship when people are signing up to vote.
So none of this happens in a political vacuum. You have one side saying that this is about voter fraud and making sure we minimize that, and then the other side saying this is an opportunity to disenfranchise minority or poor voters who might not have birth certificates. So how does this play out nationally?
Well, the simple case to look at is Kansas right now. That's the best example. In that case, you have 15,000 voter registration forms that are being held up as they're checking that additional citizenship documentation that they've provided. On the other hand, critics of these laws are saying it's only really a handful of cases that have ever been shown that somebody has falsified their citizenship. So you're holding up these 15,000 people on account of a very small number of cases that there could be voter fraud in that case. So you extrapolate that out to more states. If more states start passing these laws, and we start running into a lot of people that could be affected by this.
And is this a states' rights versus federal rights?
Exactly. This kind of follows up with what we've been seeing for several years now with immigration enforcement, for example. Arizona started that off in 2010, passing a bill that allowed state officers to enforce immigration laws a little bit more stringently. That ended up in the U.S. Supreme Court. The Supreme Court in that case ruled that the federal government is the one that has the ultimate power to enforce immigration laws, and that the states have to defer to the federal government. So this is kind of going, this is part of that broader fight. And in this voter registration case, for example, there was another ruling by the U.S. Supreme Court last year where the Supreme Court ruled that, again, it's the federal government that has authority. So in that case, these states, Arizona in particular, was required to accept federal voter registration forms that did not include the additional proof of citizenship that they're now requiring. And so this is another step in that battle.
And finally, this is likely to be appealed?
Absolutely.
All right. Alan Gomez from USA Today, thanks so much.
Thank you.